I have time to speak. There barely was a lesson learned. Cause it will return no favors back to me. I'm sure it tasted oh so sweet, but it was never good enough for me. I bit the tongue behind my teeth. It was never good enough for me. You say you always keep your word. Show me what you're after. I thought you promised me the world. Tell me what you're after. Just a little faster. Are mine the only eyes that see? So steadily, this cut and dry routine. Even when you're by my side, I still need time to feel the company. I'm sure it tasted oh so sweet, but it was never good.
Hey folks, it's Jamie Jimmy Capone. Welcome to another exciting episode of I.W.E. TV. And our first bout features the odd couple of Fantastic Kyle Huntley and Mason X taking on the bomb squad of Crash Landing and John the Bomb Dyer. And then our second match features a rematch from a few weeks back as the Wild Man, Larry Wilder, the man from Mount Fog, will take on the Crazy Man, the hardcore icon of the I.W.E. Cactus. And in our main event, folks, it's tag team action as Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams, and Jonathan Alexander Primer will team up to take on Scotty Bygaw of Vegas and Pittsfield's own Aaron Anderson. But at this time, let's send to a little video package with Wah.
Capital Punishment, November 4th in Fairfield, Maine. You guys are going to take me out. Now, we've gone back and forth between companies, whether it be how I.W.E., NWA on Fire. We've been there, we've done that, but there's still unfinished business. Now, my normal partner, who is fucking Fahrenheit and the Potty Boys, can't make it, so I had to find a suitable replacement. And this guy, he's a world record holder. He was on Stanley's Superhuman. He's actually a former I.W.E. Tag Team Champion. And, he's kind of angry. Come on in, buddy.
Capital Punishment! When we're through with you, I'm gonna make sure I put you 6 feet under.
And when he's done, I'm gonna dance on your grave. I'll see you guys in Fairfield. Peace out!
Hey, folks, quick reminder. Friday, November 4th at the Fairfield Community Center is IW's return to Fairfield. Great night of IW wrestling action, 7:30 bell time, $8 intermission, $10 front row tickets, you can't beat that. Plus the return of Shockwave the Robot, only 2 weeks away, folks, you don't want to miss that. Also, we'll have some singles action as members of the Bomb Squad and the Lost Alliance will take on each other, as Scott Wilde will take on Crash Landing, and Johnny Miyagi will take on John the Bomb Briar, and you also heard it just earlier, as Capital Punishment will take on another than myself, and the Extreme Strongman, Stan Lee's Superhuman Zone, Gino Martino. Folks, you're not going to miss that. Great IW action coming to Fairfield, Maine, November 4th. Don't miss that. And then, obviously, the very next night, don't miss it, as IW returns to Brewer, Maine at Cityside Restaurant, 7:30 bell time. Great action in Brewer. $8 general admission, $10 front row tickets. Can't beat that. You come out and see the IW's first ever barbed wire match. We're going to take down the ropes and put up barbed wires. Cactus will take on Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams. Also, it's a rematch as Jonathan Alexander Primer and Scotty Bygaw Vegas go head-to-head in an I Quit match for the IW Championship. Folks, you're not going to miss that. Also, the IW Tag Team titles will be on the line as the Lost Alliance will defend in a rematch against the Capital Punishment. Folks, you're not going to miss that. Also, don't forget, you'll also see a great matchup between Gino Martino taking on Fantastic Kyle Huntley for the IW television title and the newly upgraded Shockwave the Robot will be in the house. But at this time, let's take it to a video package with Cactus.
Pull up! Warrior! Hey! Bob Warrior!
Hey folks, this is Jive and Jimmy Capone. Welcome to an exciting episode of I.W.E. TV. And our first matchup features the current I.W.E. television champion, Fantastic Kyle Huntley, here teaming up with his odd partner here, Mason X, to take on the Bomb Squad.
Mason X is going to team with Kyle Huntley. I don't... That's quite
hey,
the pair.
Money talks.
I don't know if you pay me.
And now that Kyle Huntley's got the television title, I'm sure he's got something to spread around.
I think you have to pay Lawless to get Mason X. I don't think Mason X knows
what money is. I'm pretty sure that's what he did. But, I mean, what better partner? I mean, honestly, it's Mason X. That's a beast of a man.
He frightens me. I hope that someday someone could, you know, topple the big man. But I haven't seen him get beat very often.
He is the human horror, Bill.
He frightens me, Jimmy. He frightens me. I shake a little when I see him.
I'm shaking a little right now just seeing Kyle Huntley. Jesus Christ. Look at him.
I don't know what he said, bad stuff.
I don't like the man.
Well, he stole your television title. He stole it. He did not win it. He stole it.
It wasn't all him. It was Ron Michaels. That's what it is. And I got some words later on in the show from Ryan Michaels. But here comes Mason X.
And there's that card piece wearing freak show, Marion Lawless.
Yeah, Marion Lawless, the leader of the Lawless Alliance. Composes Mason X, Johnny Miyagi, and Scott Wilde.
That's quite the gaggle of the rogues gallery, I like to say. That's quite the rogues gallery of people.
They're rather lost boys of the IWE.
But that little girl does not seem to like Mason X.
Lawless had to grab Mason X to keep him from ripping the kid's head off.
He might have tried to eat her.
Maybe. He might be hungry.
He probably has to remove
an I was trying to intimidate these fans here in the front row. They're getting a front row seat there for this mammoth of a man. Oh, no, scary little old lady. What's up with this man? What is wrong with him?
I don't know. I've been doing this for a while with you, and I don't rightly know what the heck is wrong with Mason X.
Well, Mason X obviously has some issues, and Marion Lawless here, it's kind of that man who tries to keep the man controlled and uses Mason X for his dirty work.
You think Marion Lawless keeps him in his basement?
Probably chained to the radiator.
I wouldn't be surprised if he just throws a mistake every now and again to keep him regulated.
Steak or, maybe a whole rotisserie chicken.
Ooh, those are delicious.
Yeah, they're pretty different. And now Kyle Holland telling Joey Glean to hold open the ropes for Marion Lawless here. Now, obviously, you can tell Kyle Holland has paid Marion Lawless to use Mason X, and this is obviously a planned action here. Is they're going to take on the Bomb Squad, I'll say this, have had strong showings against the Lawless Alliance League.
They sure have, but I'm not sure if they're going to be able to topple Superstar quite as Kyle Huntley, and he's got Mason X on his side, so...
Well, I think that's why Marion Lawless was more than happy to lend Mason X to this matchup, is because I'm sure his feelings for the Bomb Squad aren't that strong in the positive sense.
I have to agree with you. Marion Lawless does not like to see the Lawless Alliance get beat around by the Bomb Squad, so he's going to bring out the largest member of the Bomb Squad and have a team with Kyle Huntley.
That's right, and that's the neutralizer. Mason X is the neutralizer for John the Bomb, pretty much for this matchup. John the Bomb, the powerhouse of the team, obviously adds a lot to the green for the Bomb Squad.
I agree with you there, but I'm still afraid of Mason X and what he's going to do to crash the ending. He might kill the poor man.
He might. I mean, but I'll give Crash Landing can take quite the beating. I mean, he can take quite the amount of punishment. We've seen it from the Lawless Alliance numerous times. I'm surprised he's kicked out of some things I've seen him, but he may be the smallest man in the matchup, but he's got the biggest heart.
Agreed. I agree with you there, but I don't know how you prepare for opponents as Mason X. I keep talking up Mason X, and I'm not really talking him up. I'm just talking up how much I am afraid of him. I just fear. It runs down my back.
John the Bomb not scared of Mason X at all. Obviously standing up. These two big men ready to collide here. Crash Landing, though, ready to jump in the ring and go right at Kyle Huntley. He's ready and raring to go. He's fired up.
He really is. And we've seen Lawless send Mason X to help several other people as well. He just sends them out there.
I think Kyle Huntley hiding behind Mason X. And obviously the tactics here, Marion Lawless probably using Mason X to do some dirty work on the Bomb Squad. And Kyle Huntley is obviously reaping the benefits.
He sure is. Newly crowned television champion, I'm sorry, but he is.
Don't remind me.
Under dirty, dirty circumstances. Now he's got Mason X out there, so who else is Kyle Huntley going to have on his side? We've seen him use several people lately.
There's always the numbers game involved when you have Marion Lawless, Lawless Lions, and of course Kyle Huntley. They'll do whatever they can to win matches, and we've seen it over the last couple weeks here on IWTV. and not just win matches, but also retain their titles.
That's very, very true. And if they were smart, they might bring Mason X to the ring with them more often. He might be able to secure the victories more.
Well, they do have Marion Lawless, and Marion Lawless does bring that chain to ringside, that chain usually around the neck of Mason X. Yeah, Mason X kind of let him go free today, which kind of surprises me, but I think it's more the fact that he's got Mason X riled up and ready to go to take on the Bomb Squad.
That could be a bad idea, though. Let Mason X on the loose, I fear. Everyone hide their women and children and their snack cakes, because Mason X is on his way.
Mason X, though, obviously not going to start this matchup, but it looks like Kyle Huntley going to start this matchup with Big John the Bomb. I don't know if this is a great idea for Kyle Huntley, but hey, I'm not going to complain. Look at Kyle Huntley. I can't take this. This is disgusting.
That is.
This man flusters me to the peak of my existence. I can't stand the man, and I can't, just as much as I can't stand Ryan Michaels, which I'll talk about later.
I don't like either one of them as well. I'm in the same boat as you. They're both just despicable people, and I have no respect for people like that at all.
Well, you know, I don't have respect for them either. I mean, they do what they can to keep themselves on the top, and they can't win matches. I mean, what is the deal? They can't take the actions in their own hands. They have to use everybody else.
Seems to be quite the tactics here in the WWE.
Well, just for the Lawless Alliance and Kyle Huntley, it seems to me.
True. We also see Jonathan Palmer with his bodyguards, and they all seem to get involved.
They're paid bodyguards, though. I mean, there's not much you can do about it. They have a license to be there. What can they do about it?
Well, Lawless has a manager's license, so he can be there. But I don't think he's licensed to wield that chain.
No, definitely not. And this match has yet to get started here. Kyle Huntley playing some mind games here. With John the Bomb, and John the Bomb not letting it get to him, which is smart. John the Bomb wants to go at this strong and fast and take Kyle Huntley out early, which is smart. And John the Bomb, obviously the bigger man, pushing Kyle Huntley right in the corner.
Well, the Bomb Squad is in top contention for those tag team titles, and who knows what a loss could mean for them here. Maybe that could mean they lose their spot.
Well, you know, the Bomb Squad is not very happy that on November 5th in Brewer, Maine, it will be Capital Punishment taking on the Lawless Alliance in a tag title rematch. So they're using their rematch clause. They have a right to do it, and they're doing it on November 5th. I can't believe that the Bomb Squad got screwed, literally, last week here on IW TV.
We saw that the Lawless Alliance used a disqualification at the end, and that's how they're
doing what they can to retain the titles, and it's ridiculous. I mean, Sonny Roselli was even the referee, and he couldn't. He called it right down the middle and the best he could, and he even got involved a little bit. And this match has turned up a notch quick. His big hip toss and a clothesline. John the Bomber was taking Kyle Huntley out of his boots.
Maybe he's going to knock some of that hair off his chest.
Oh, military press on Kyle Huntley. Kyle Huntley's seeing stars. Oh, as he eats the mat.
John the Bomb is using his power against Kyle Huntley. Kyle Huntley trying to tag in Mason X.
Kyle Huntley just flailing, trying to tag in Mason X. Mason X makes the tag. Coming out of the corner, big clothesline. Oh, ducks it. Big clothesline off the ropes from John the Bomb.
I've never seen Mason X toss around like this.
Oh, got him up now. What's he going to do here? John the Bomb has picked up Mason X here. Big body slam on the monster.
I just can't believe that he's doing such a thing to Mason X.
And Mason X drags himself to the corner here, trying to get, and tags back in Kyle Huntley. Kyle Huntley not getting any breathers. And Mason X did not do any good there for Kyle Huntley at all. And Kyle Huntley staying in the corner, says he does not want John the Bomb. He wants Crash Landing in the match right now. Of course he wants Crash Landing.
Of course he wants the easier opponent.
What's up with that? I mean, you want John the Bomb on a roll. Kyle Huntley says he wants Crash Landing. And John the Bomb says, let's go. Obviously, Kyle Huntley hugging close to his corner so that he can get that rope break if he needs to, or tag back in Mason X. But here we go, as the tag's been made, and John the Bomb tags in Crash Landing.
Hopefully we see Crash Landing, you know, show up, Kyle Huntley. Crash Landing is still quite the rookie in here, so hopefully we can see some of the moves that he likes to do to Kyle Huntley.
And tie up here, obviously Kyle has got the height advantage on Crash Landing, and using it, pushing him back toward the corner. And a rope break here, and I think Kyle just slapped Crash Landing in the face. Crash Landing coming right after Kyle, and Kyle gets out of that.
Kyle's running like she's scared. He's running, just running away from Crash Landing. I thought that's who he wanted.
I think so too, but I think he bit off more than he could chew.
Agreed.
And I'll say these two men about to square up one more time. Lock up. And Kyle Huntley once again pushing, crash landing to the corner here, trying to keep use the height and weight advantage and keep him crash landing in the corner. And crash landing probably not liking that as he gets slapped in the face again. And crash landing trying to go after Kyle Huntley. Kyle Huntley positioning himself between himself and Joey Gleitz there, trying to keep Joey Gleitz in the way of crash landing.
These are just silly tactics from Kyle Huntley, using every advantage at all possible to him to try to distract crash landing. Ridiculousness, Jimmy.
And it looks like these two men about to score up one more time here. And Kyle takes a short, cheap way out. Now going on the attack on crash landing, almost knocks him out of the ring.
Almost knocked him into our cameraman right there.
Cameraman almost got a face full of crash landing. And crash landing in a lot of pain now. And he's down on the mat, and Kyle Huntley taking advantage of it. And there's this cheap chokehold here by Kyle Huntley, and Joey Gleitz string a count.
Kyle Huntley again just using those dirty, underhanded tactics to try to defeat, and he's going over there to distract John the Bomb.
Well, John the Bomb, and now look at this. Now Mason X taking advantage while the referee's distracted by John the Bomb. And cheap tactics once here played out, and John the Bomb not doing his partner any favors. Needs to get out of Dodge. Kyle Huntley has now got crash landing down and has him, looks like, right where he wants him, but they're just toying with crash landing, and it's going to take more than that to put out crash landing. We've seen him take so much punishment in the past, and now a stomach claw. I mean, the stomach claw, who brings out the stomach claw? I haven't seen that in years.
I haven't seen that since 1946.
That far back?
Yep, that was the last time I saw it.
That's a little far.
It is quite far, Jimmy. It is.
That's like over, that's almost 60 years.
Well, now you're aging me, Jimmy, okay? Stop telling everyone how old I am.
Okay. You old fogey. Anyway, stomach claw by Kyle Huntley. As Kyle Huntley lets go, I mean, the stomach claw, folks, as Mason X is in now, and he's using the stomach claw.
I have seen him do that a few times before. So maybe it wasn't 1946.
Yeah, you
maybe
lie.
Maybe it was 1972.
You're a big liar.
Not a liar, just an exaggerator. There's a difference.
You're a fibber.
A fibber? How about a fabricator?
Fabricator?
Yes.
You make stuff?
Yes, I do.
You fabricate?
Yes, I make tea.
Oh, okay.
I fabricate tea.
You fabricate tea as Kyle Huntley chokes crash landing in the corner. And looks like a little tag team work here as the referee is distracted. And John the Bomb is slowly getting out of the ring here. He stay in his corner. He's not doing crash landing any feints over in the corner of Kyle Huntley and Mason X, which does not serve well for him. Kyle Huntley, he's got crash landing. Brings him to the buckle now. What's he going to do? He's got him in the buckle. Kyle Huntley's got him in the corner here. Whips him into the other buckle now. Kyle Huntley charges in and misses that splash. It gets rolled up by crash landing. Going for pit now. One, two, but a kick out. Crash landing out of nowhere with that schoolboy. Tried to get a pin there, and he's close to the corner, but he gets cut down by Kyle Huntley. Kyle Huntley, knowing his ring presence there, cuts down crash landing, trying to keep him from making the tag. Now, great finds the leg as Kyle reaches to make the tag to Mason X. Mason X shot to John the Bomb. John the Bomb furious shows to come in here, and he's not doing any favors for crash landing right now. Mason X has got the leg worked over, and he's got him down on the mat, trying to keep him based and down on the mat. The human horror film, trying to lay in the punishment to crash landing here, and John the Bomb needs to make a tag here, but crash landing still down and out here from Mason X and Kyle Huntley's abuse as he lays on the mat here. He's so close, but he cannot reach to make that tag. He's so close. He's about a yard away. He can reach up and try to get to his feet and make that tag. That would be in the best stake for crash landing here. As it looks like Kyle Huntley back in now, trying, he's rolling crash landing over. I don't know what he's setting him up for. Crash landing in the middle of the ring now. It looks like Kyle Huntley going up. He's going up top. And it's not normally something we see from Kyle Huntley. He's up on the top rope. Comes off with an elbow, but nothing. No water in the pool. Crash landing makes a tag to John the Bomb. He's a tag. John the Bomb comes in right after Kyle Huntley. Pushes him in the ropes and whips him off. Kyle Huntley eats a clothesline from John the Bomb Breyer. John the Bomb on a roll here, trying to deal some punishment to Kyle Huntley. And now Mason X eats one clothesline by his own. Mason X not doing too well himself, as it looks like Kyle Huntley gets dumped out to the outside. And John the Bomb grabs a hold of Mason X. Now he's got him up. And it looks like he's going for that front slam. As John the Bomb has planted Mason X, the human horror film. And he's over the corner now. What's he going to do? He's got crash landing. Makes a tight crash landing. Oh, wait a minute. We're going to see an old school rocket launcher right now. A rocket launcher. No way. Oh, that's it. Rocket launcher. Over the pin. One, two, and three. That's it. John the Bomb and crash landing. The Bomb Squad pull out a win out of nowhere on Mason X with that rocket launcher. I never saw that coming. That's the first ever for the Bomb Squad with that rocket launcher. That must be their new move they've been trying to do. And it's certainly effective on Mason X here as they come out on top of this matchup. Marion Lawless tried to do his best here, lending Mason X to Kyle Huntley in this tag match, and it just did not pay off as the Bomb Squad get another big win as they hope to take on Marion Lawless's Lawless Alliance here. As Lawless is obviously upset from this, but the Bomb Squad a big win nonetheless. John the Bomb fired up, happy that they finally got a big win here that they've been needing. Obviously frustrated after last week's event there with the Lawless Alliance, who skewed their title. Obviously they're on a goal to get themselves the IWE tag team titles here. It's only a matter of time. They've been going after the Lawless Alliance over the last, I'd say, months, actually. And now they've actually maybe getting their opportunity. But first, Capital Punishment gets their opportunity November 5th. And Brewer at Seaside Restaurant as they cash in the rematch against the Lawless Alliance. And so, guys, you don't want to miss that. November 5th, Brewer, Maine, Seaside Restaurant. Folks, another reminder, Friday, November 4th, Fairfield Community Center. You're not going to miss this. As IW comes back to Fairfield with a great night of IW wrestling action, 7:30 bell time, $8 general admission, $10 front row tickets. You can't beat that. It's the return of Shock Raider the Robot, only 2 weeks away, folks. You don't want to miss it. Also, the Lawless Alliance and the Bomb Squad will feast off in singles matches. As Scott Wilde will take on Crash Landing, and Jimmy Yagi will take on John the Bomb Breyer. Also, you heard it earlier on this evening, it will be Capital Punishment taking on none other than myself and Gino Martino, the Extreme Strongman and Stan Lee's Superhuman Zone. Folks, it's going to be great tag team action in Fairfield, Maine, so don't miss it. Friday, November 4th, Fairfield Community Center. And don't forget, the very next night, the IW returning to Cityside Restaurant in Brewer, Maine. That's right, November 5th, 7:30 bell time, $8 general admission, $10 front row. Can't beat that. And you'll see Shockwave the Robot House. Gino Martino will also be facing Fantastic Kyle Huntley, IW television title. The Lawless Alliance will be defending the tag team title against Capital Punishment in a rematch. Also, first ever barbed wire match. We're taking down the road, putting up barbed wire. As Cactus will take on Miss Hannah and Ricky Williams. Also, in an I Quit match for the IW title will be Skybagai Vegas defending in a rematch against former champion Jonathan Alexander Primer, folks. But at this time, I got to send it to the back. We got a video package we just received from Mayan Michaels and folks. I can't believe I've already seen this video, so I'm going to show it to you right now. So we're going to see this video clip from Ryan Mice.
Ryan Michaels, or somebody there else come back or something like that?
I don't know, man. What's... He's been around kicking people's butt. You have you heard about that?
No, I really haven't. I mean, I really don't know what's going on around here.
I don't either.
It's really, really...
Have IWE go get a sponsor! Tell IWE to go get a sponsor! You
folks. John and Jimmy here with our second matchup of today's show. And we will feature the Wild Man, Larry Wilder, taking on the Crazy Man, Cactus.
I'm just horrified. I'm horrified at this match. These two men, one barks and one says pop pop. I don't think either of them know how to speak English at all, so.
It means Vernon Andy must be the interpreter. Well, this isn't the first time these two men have met, and Vernon Andy actually asked for the rematch. And I don't think that's very smart, because we know Cactus's been carrying good old Barbie wire around with him.
I don't know what that thing. Dug it up. It's an old relic.
That barbed wire baseball bat. He's
been like 2 years.
He's been bringing that thing to the ring with him, and that thing is dangerous.
It sure is.
And I wouldn't have to rematch with a man who carries a barbed wire baseball bat. He might have a feeling like he wants to use it on you.
It might get stuck in Larry Wilder's back hair, though.
Oh, he may be able to use it to shave it, actually.
Maybe he should.
Yeah, maybe he should. But Cactus on his way to ringside with Barbie Wire. And Cactus, I don't know what to say about Cactus. He is one crazy man. He is the hardcore icon of the I.W.E. He loves Barbie Wire.
He sure does.
His girlfriend.
It is. And I don't want to know when he takes off dates, but we'll see, I guess.
My question is he the third wheel?
He always is.
Oh, okay.
And he never pays the bill.
No, never does.
Nope.
Well, I don't want to know what Sako eats. But anyway, as Cactus is in the ring, and it looks like this match is getting underway here, as Barbie Wire is in the corner here by Cactus, trying to keep a good close eye on her, you know?
I think he talks to that thing. I really do. Hit Sako and the barbed wire bat, I think they all have conversations.
I've seen him kissing them and licking it.
I saw that too. It's just gross.
Yucky.
A few years back, we saw that he had that thing.
Slowly, Cactus has been slowly changing. He no longer wears his IWE shirt. He comes out with no shirt, actually. He has Sako blatantly hanging out of his hand. He has a torn up flannel now, and he shaved his head. I mean, the man is changing. He's getting nuttier by the minute.
I think he's slowly slipping more into insanity each wrestling show we see him on.
And his target normally as of late has been Mr. Canada Ricky Williams, who is not liked it whatsoever.
Would you like a man chasing you the barbed wire bat who's dressed like a football coach? I would not.
I'd agree. As these two men look evenly matched, Derek, that lockup, no one took any advantage there. No one was able to gain any leverage. This is a big man match, so we're not going to see a lot of technical wrestling tonight.
I really don't think we're going to see handlebots. I think we're going to see punches to the face and maybe some barbed wire bats, some headbutts, and
a lot of barking.
Yeah, that's probably what we're going to see.
And maybe some back hair pulling.
I hope I don't see that. That's just gross. It's gross and horrible.
Can't be any crazy.
He sure is crazy, Jimmy. I tried to have a conversation with him once. We tried to do an interview segment, and all he said was pop pop, so I just got up and left.
And both men fighting over this test of strength now. It looks like Wilder in control, has him in the corner. And it looks like he's going to charge in. Looks like he's going for that big splash in the corner. And he does not get it. There's no one there for that big splash as he eats the corner.
He might actually eat the corner if he stays there long enough.
Yum, yum in the tummy. George the Animal Steel. Number two.
We have seen Larry Wilder go in with a stick sometimes, eating a stick.
Gnawing on a stick to his chew toy.
That's just odd. Odd.
They do make doggy treats that you can buy. They're relatively cheap.
I don't think I want to buy anything for him. He frightens me.
Cactus, obviously he doesn't frighten Cactus as all as he's attacking Larry Wilder, and Larry Wilder, the Wild Man, is not doing so well here against the Crazy Man Cactus.
Well, you have to give Larry Wilder some, I don't know what you have to give him, but he's facing Cactus again after the brutal matchup they had before.
Well, I don't think it's really him, it's more Vernon Envy who's on the contract for him. That's
him. Larry Wilder signed it with P. Write his name.
I have seen him attempt to earn him, but Larry Wilder out on the floor here, taking a little breather. As Cactus going out after him now. Cactus now going forward here. And Cactus going around the corner here, but Larry Wilder laying in wait as he hits that clothesline on Cactus.
Larry Wilder is very smart. He's on the floor. That's Cactus's home. Cactus prefers to be on the floor than in the ring.
Well, I think It's more of that bait and switch, you know what I'm saying? Larry Wilder, the Wild Man, was out there getting a little breather, saw Cactus coming, Cactus wasn't ready, and got laywayed by that clothesline on the floor. That's the cement floor.
It is a cement floor, and it's quite hot. I've seen one of them.
So you get the impact of the actual clothesline, and you get the impact you hitting the floor.
I think Cactus likes pain, though. He always has a smile, so he's getting beat up.
And now Larry Wilder up on the second row. He has that back senton, and almost squishes the life out of Cactus.
Unless the man would have died from that. Did you see the height that Larry Wilder got on that?
I think it was more of gravity more than height. That was all that weight onto the sternum of Cactus. He's going up for number two now. What? If he hits this, it could be the end of Cactus. I don't know. Second time. No water in the pool for Larry Wilder either. And that dog did need a bath.
He sure did. I think I went on it.
Soap?
Soap.
Probably eat it.
It's true, he might. Might take a big bite out of the soap.
All right. Bite it and chew on it. And now Cactus in control now. Cactus got hooked up for that double arm DDT as he plants Larry Wilder right in the middle of the ring. And now he's going for that sock. As he's going, he's got Mr. Socko.
I think that's it for Larry Wilder. Once the sock comes out, it's over.
That's it. The sock's coming out. And we saw this happen last time with Larry Wilder. He's got the sock. It's time for Mr. Socko.
Gross. Well, I don't know. What's worse, Larry Wilder's mouth or the sock?
It doesn't matter. You couldn't tell between the smell of the breath and the smell of the sock. As Larry Wilder eats Mr. Socko, he's down. He's down for the count here. And this could be it. 1, 2, and 3. Looks like Cactus gets a big win over Larry Wilder as he's not letting go.
Cactus, as I said, he's just losing the punishment more, so he's just delivering more punishment to Larry Wilder. That'll teach him to have a second.
Larry Wilder getting dumped out to the floor now, and Cactus standing tall here in the ring as he is once again beating Larry Wilder right here in front of these fans.
Unbelievable. Cactus again with another victory.
Folks, I'm going to give you a little heads up. I was told today, a big announcement from Cactus has announced there will be a fatal four-way for the IW Championship. Cactus versus Primer versus Williams versus Vegas and Fairfield on the 4th of November. At this time, we're going to stand in the back with supporters from Vegas and Primer.
So moments after I win this title, the ones I've been chasing for so long, be it Capone with it, be it Primer with it, whomever. The captain decides, I'm going to throw two title matches at you next month. And usually you'd see people on here whining and complaining. This boy's smiling ear to ear. Because I am a fighting champion. I'm going to prove it. I'm going to prove I can topple all. Because that is what it means. That's what it means to be a champion. To be the top of your game, top of the company. To give everybody who pays a ticket something worth seeing. And the examples start on November 4th in Fairfield, Maine, where it's going to be four men, one title. Myself defending this title against Cactus, a man who's been in this business for 15 years. He's kooky, but you can't underestimate him. Jonathan Alexander Primer. A guy who I have hated since we started in 2003. We've been at each other's necks like two bulldogs locked in a death grip. Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams. A hell of a technician. Is he ready for this title? We're going to find out November 4th. But if I have my way about it, I'm going to stay champion. I'm going to continue to show everybody that it is Scott Vegas' time to shine. That is the by God truth.
I don't know what Captain thinks he's doing to Jonathan Alexander Primer. I'm a former champion. He wants to book this fatal four-way with Cactus. What has Cactus done lately? He goes, pop, pop! He comes up with a barbed wire bat. No one cares about Cactus. And then we get the guy from Canada who's Mr. Canada. I've seen better things come out of a moose's ass than Mr. Canada. And then we have Scotty Vegas. Everyone knows the history between me and Scotty Vegas. He wants to be in this fatal four-way. He is the new I.W.E. champion. So you know what, Scotty Vegas? Look right here. November 4th, this is the last thing you're going to see before I end your career.
Quick reminder, folks, Friday, November 4th at the Fairfield Community Center. It's Ida B coming back to Fairfield, 7:30 bell time. Can't miss it. You just heard the great announcement and you've heard from some of the competitors. It'll be a fatal four-way match for the IW Championship as Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams, Jonathan Alexander Primer, Cactus, and the defending champion, Scotty Vega Vegas, will face off in a fatal four-way match. That's right, a fatal four-way for the IW Championship. Folks, you do not want to miss this matchup, Fairfield Vane, Friday, November 4th. You also don't want to miss the very next night as we're coming back to Cityside Restaurant in Brewer, Maine. Well, the IW's first barbed wire match. We're taking down the ropes and putting up some barbed wires. Cactus will take on Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams. Also, be the IW title rematch between Vegas and Primer with an I Quit match. You're not going to miss that. The IW tag team title has also been in line as Lost Lions to defend in a rematch against Capital Punishment. Also, Stan Lee's Superhuman Zone. Gino Martino will take on Fantastic Kyle Huntley for the IW TV title. At this time, I'll send it to the back with some words from Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams.
This is Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams. On November 4th, Fairfield, Maine, I get opportunity of a lifetime, and I don't even have to use this. November 4th, I got a four-way dance. Four-way dance, eh? For the IWE Championship. It's gonna be me versus that fat piece of crap so-called wrestler wannabe Cactus. Versus the former champion Primer versus the new IW champion Scotty, oh by God, Vegas. But let me tell you something. This is unfair for Mr. Canada, because I gotta face not one, not two, but three opponents for that title. You know what? With all the accolades and all the discriminations, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, eh? Because I will walk out of Fairfield, Maine, as the IW champion. Why? Because I'm Mr. Canada. Why? Because I'm the greatest technician wrestler there is. Why? Because there ain't nobody better than me. Oh, Canada!
Well, folks, it's main event time. Tag Captain is Pittsfield Zone Aaron with Scotty by God is the team take on the odd team of Jonathan Alexander Primer and Mr. Canada Ricky Williams.
That is quite the odd pairing. Those two men don't really like each other very much.
Actually, I don't think any of these men like each other except for Vegas and Aaron Anderson probably don't really have any problems with one another. So I'm going to put my money on them if I was a betting man.
I would also put my money on them because Primer seems to have lost a step since he lost that title, so I'm not really sure how he's going to fare in this match.
I'm not sure either, but, I mean, Vegas is the new IW champion, but with that new announcement of the Fatal 4-Way, November 4th, the Fairfield Community Center, I'm sure all these men are going to be having their eyes peeled against each other, obviously going to have those eyes in the back of their head.
I think you have to grow eyes in the back of your head, because we saw how crazy Cactus is, and he could still be waiting in the wings out there, because he's the other competitor in that match, so who knows where he could come from.
Well, he just wrestled earlier in this episode, folks, so you never know what could happen here. Williams and Primer trying to get on the same page, but obviously does not seem to be working.
It's not going to work, Jimmy. They both want the same thing. They both want the IW title. So you're a former IW champion. You don't want to be on the same page with these two men.
No, you don't. Not when all three out of the four men in this matchup are aiming to have the IW Championship, and one of them actually does. It's not going to be in a good favor. You're not going to be in good favor with anybody in this match.
Vegas doesn't even need to be pinned in the Fatal 4-Way. Jonathan Primer could outpin Ricky Williams and win the title. The champion does not have to be pinned.
That is true, as Vegas is trying to get this thing started off right. He's got a hold of Mr. Canada, Ricky Williams, and Aaron Anderson here, Pittsfield Zone, and it's going to be interesting to see how this works here, folks. As you can tell here, I think Aaron Anderson and Vegas are going to be more on the same page, and Williams and Primer.
I have to agree with you. Don't forget, Clown's bodyguards are on the outside, so it's really poor on too, really.
It is, that is true, but I mean, for them to get involved, there has to be some type of distraction, and that, you know, where the Aaron Anderson is probably going to be keeping an eye out where he's on the apron of the matchup.
It's true, but you never know what could happen. You never know, Jimmy. And Mr. Canada in Vegas is starting to, you know, quite hard. Vegas is tooling around Mr. Canada. He's showing him who's boss.
And now Aaron Anderson, and they're going to do a little teamwork on this man here. It looks like they're setting him for a tag team suplex here. They're going to suplex him over, and they hit the big suplex here on Williams, and Williams is down. He's in a lot of pain right now.
He really is. I'm not sure if Primer even cares if he's in a lot of pain. He's out on the outside and just... He doesn't seem very worried about
it. Well, this match isn't for the title, so I wouldn't be worried either. I mean, he probably has no care in the world right now.
It's true. It really is true.
He might not even care about winning this matchup. All he wants probably is the IW Championship back.
Well, he did lose it in that brutal, brutal matchup, so that could be all on his back, and he could care less if he gets a victory in the tank. He still has the shot at the title.
That is true, and looks as if here Aaron Anderson in control on Williams, and Williams in a lot of pain. Looks like Aaron Anderson suplexes Williams over here, and Williams eating the mat there from that suplex. Williams getting thrown around a little bit by Aaron Anderson in Vegas here in this matchup.
Well, they are working well as a team. You saw that double suplex. And Aaron Anderson trying to get a pin, but he just doesn't have enough yet to get the pin on Mr. Candy Ricky Williams.
Williams taking a lot of abuse, probably not liking one bit of it, but Primer just standing in the corner and waiting for his opportunity.
That's what he does. He's an opportunist. He's the ultimate opportunist. He's going to wait until Aaron Anderson has his back turned. He'll probably come in and do something dirty.
Oh, big chops from Aaron Anderson on Williams, and Williams not liking that at all. He howls in pain.
Primer's not even paying attention to the match. Look at the look on his face. He doesn't even care that Ricky Williams is getting tossed around like a sack of potatoes.
No, he doesn't. At one point, Williams hit Primer with that Canadian hockey stick there that's wrapped up the Canadian flag. He's hit Primer on numerous occasions with that hockey stick. He's also in Vegas as well.
All these men just hate each other. That's really what it is, except for Aaron Anderson and
Vegas.
They like each other quite a bit.
Well, they're obviously working together well, so that's a good sign here. As it looks like Vegas is back in. He's got a hold of Williams here. Vegas obviously looking to do some damage to Williams after those stick shots we talked about just a few weeks ago.
It's payback, you know. Miss Canada Ricky Williams has it coming. He likes to hit people with hockey sticks, so he's going to feel pain on his own.
Well, Williams now getting dumped to the floor by Vegas. And this gives Williams a little bit of a breather, I think. But no such luck. I think Primer's going to throw him back in and throw him to the Wolves.
I thought they were supposed to be looking as a team. It looks like that's
so.
Looking down.
Well, he's getting in there. He's breaking up the pin. But, I mean, he literally threw Williams to the Wolves.
Well, I suppose that's what happens. Maybe he wants Mr. Canada in there to soften him up a little bit.
Well, Mr. Canada getting a couple shots in on Vegas now. Showing some actual offense here from Williams on Vegas. Vegas cuts him short and slams the man in the ring there with a body slam.
Interesting, but I'm still kind of baffled that Primer just threw Mr. Canada back in the ring.
He didn't let him take a breather. He just threw him back in the ring.
Ridiculous design. It's breaking down here. That's what happens in tag team matches.
Vegas getting whipped in, but Brutus pulls down the top rope.
I told you, it was only a matter of time before the bodyguards got involved in the matchup.
I'm not even sure Gleed saw it. Dalton was on the apron, distracting the referee, and he pulled down the rope, and Vegas went right to the floor. And Primer dealing some damage to Vegas out here on the floor as Williams is working over Aaron Anderson in the ring.
I think Brutus is actually helping him out, too. I see Brutus laying in a couple shots to Vegas as well.
Well, Brutus did enough by just pulling down that top rope. Vegas soared over the top of the ring.
Definitely did not look like it felt good. They have a little bit of padding, but it's still right on that wood floor.
So wood floor there is Williams now in control on Vegas. He did some damage to Aaron Anderson. Aaron Anderson wasn't very much help there. Referee distracted by Dalton.
It's the first time we saw Primer and Williams work as a team, kind of. I think that's about as good as he's going to get on this.
I think so, but it looks like blind tag by Primer. He's in. He's going to hit a chin breaker on Vegas out of nowhere. And he made a blind tag to Williams. What was up with that? Williams wasn't even ready to get out yet.
I think Primer just hates Vegas so much. He thinks he's nice and soft, and he's getting in there to beat up Vegas.
Vegas on the receiving end now from Primer. Primer has got him right where he wants him, over in the corner here with Williams. I still don't understand why Primer would make that blind tag. I mean, I understand he doesn't like Williams, but I would want to win the match.
I think we touched upon this before. He's not concerned with winning the match because he knows he has that title match on November 4th, so maybe that's all that's on his mind here.
Yeah, that fatal four-way, and then if they survive that, they have the November 5th I Quit match between Vegas and Primer. Primer gets his rematch.
Primer using his rematch clause, but he could be the champion after the fatal four. We don't know, though. He still has to go into that I Quit match.
Aaron Anderson gets the tag. He's in now as he lays in a clothesline of Williams, and Williams rocked by Aaron Anderson here.
Primer's just watching on, and he's not coming in to help out his partner at all.
As he gets, Williams gets slammed by Aaron Anderson. Aaron Anderson now dropping an elbow.
I don't know why Primer's not helping his tag team partner. He should win the match. Isn't that the point of wrestling? Winning? Is that what you want to do?
I think so, but I'm not sure what's going on here. Primer in the referee distracted as he low blows Aaron Anderson in the corner. He waited for Joey Gleet to be distracted. And he picks him up and hits him with the rat trap.
I think this might be the end of the match. I think Aaron Anderson has it, but Mr. Canada's going for the pin.
And Primer does not like that, and neither did Vegas, but Primer pulled Williams off the cover.
I don't think he wants him to get a win without Primer's one of his favorite maneuvers. Maybe that's what it is.
Well, Primer isn't the legal man, what Williams is, technically, but I think Primer feels he did the dirty work, he should get the pin.
I think that's how he feels as well. I'm not really sure.
Vegas taking advantage here, rammed Williams into Primer here, and Williams and Primer are both down, but Williams eats a clothesline from Aaron Anderson, and of course that sets up for Vegas. He's over in the corner, he's going up, he wants to hit the ram jam
over,
and that's it. He got it. 1-2 and yes, he's got it.
He did. Vegas and Aaron Anderson beat Jonathan Alexander Primer and Mr. Kenny Rick Williams. I just don't think that
they had the match won. Williams and Primer had the match won with the rat trap. This is over.
They had it won until Primer pulled him off. He pulled Mr. Canada off.
He pulled him off the cover. I mean, Vegas tried to come in and break the cover, but I think he would have gotten the three count if Primer hadn't pulled him off.
I have to agree with you there that he should have got the cover, but he didn't. That's ridiculousness. I don't know why Primer even acted like that. He acted like a pompous jerk.
Well, I guess we're just seeing shades of what's going on. Over, obviously, November 4th, the minds of Primer and Williams in Vegas, obviously, with the showing of this matchup. And I'm sure Primer probably doesn't really care, because either way, he gets a rematch for the title on November 5th.
He does. So, but there you win it. Scotty Vegas and Aaron Anderson as they defeat Jonathan Alexander and Mr. Kendrick Williams. It was quite the match.
Williams looks to be caught in the proverbial rock and a hard place as it looks like Brutus and Dalton have cornered Williams on the outside of the ring. Williams trying to sneak out of dodge, going through the ring to get away from these two men. I don't blame him as he sneaks out of there trying to get away. Obviously, Primer and Williams not getting along, and neither is Vegas with either of these two men. And this fatal four-way coming up November 4th in Fairfield, Maine at the Fairfield Community Center. Fatal four-way for the IW Championship. And you very rarely see a fatal four-way, but these four top contenders are getting a shot. Cactus, Williams, Vegas, and Primer. Vegas, the current champion, defending. He doesn't have to be pinned. Lose the title. The first pinfall will win the person the matchup. Williams will pin Primer. Primer will pin Williams. Either make a pin Cactus. I mean, Vegas does not even have to be pinned to lose the matchup, folks. But at this time, folks, we're going to send it to a video package sent to us once again by Ryan Michaels and his associate. So, folks, let's take a look at this video package.
Why I was born to be a champion, and you were born to be a chump.
A company always on the run, a destiny. Oh, it's the rising sun. I was born a shotgun in my head.
that's why they call me.
Folks, one last reminder for the evening is it's Friday, November 4th at the Fairfield Community Center. I.W.E is coming back to Fairfield with a 7:30 bell time. Great I.W.E action in Fairfield. $8 general admission, $10 front row tickets. You can't beat that. The return of Shockwave the Robot, only 2 weeks away. Can't wait that for that. And also, you'll see tag teams separate and do some singles action. It's Crash Landing of the Bomb Squad will take on Scott Wild of Lost Alliance, as well as Johnny Miyagi of the Lost Alliance taking on John the Bomb Breyer of the Bomb Squad. Also, you heard of this episode. Earlier on in the episode, will be Capital Punishment taking on none other than myself and the Extreme Strongman, Stanley's Superhuman's Own, Gino Martino. And also, you can't forget the Fatal 4-Way matchup for the I.W.E. title is Jonathan Alexander Primer, Ricky Williams, Cactus in Vegas, 4-Way for the I.W.E. title. Can't beat that. And then the very next night at Cityside Restaurant in Brewer, Maine, that's right, November 5th, 7:30 bell time. Great action in Brewer at Cityside as I.W.E. comes back and is going to have his first ever barbed wire matchup. We're going to take the ropes down, put barbed wire up as Mr. Cano and Ricky Williams take on Cactus. Also, in an I Quit match, it will be Jonathan Alexander Primer taking on Vegas for Vegas's current I.W.E. title in a rematch. It's going to be great action, folks. Also, the I.W.E. tag team titles are on the line in a rematch as Capital Punishment finally gets their rematch against the Lawless Alliance. So much more. Gino Martino taking on Fantastic Kyle Huntley for the TV title. Also, Shockwave the Robot in the house. Well, folks, at this time, I'm going to send it to a little video package I just did the other day. And, folks, it's a little emotional for me. So let's go to that video package right now as we send it to the back with my video clip.
You know, I used to smoke a good cigar out of enjoyment. Now I smoke as a stress reliever. Because lately, I've been more worried about anything that I have in my whole life. And that's my ability to walk. You know, I've had problems with my knee in the past. Nothing really serious. Till now. And Ryan Michaels, Kyle Huntley, I got you two to blame for it. I'll give it to you, Ryan Michaels. I thought I had you scared. I thought you were going to leave after what I did to you. I saw the look in your face. I saw your cheeks turn flush red. I saw your eyes go wide. I could feel you breathing. Feel your heart rate through my hands picking up as I held you and I was ready to punch you square in the mouth. But you had enough cojones to come back out and come after me? I'll give it to you. But that's all I'm giving you. Because I'm that wild animal that you prod with a stick. You prod me enough times, and I'm gonna snap it. And I've snapped, Ryan Michaels. You've taken almost my ability to play with my kids, to walk, to run, work out, you've to do things that I normally have no problem doing in my life. You've almost taken them away from me. And that I can't stand. Ryan Michaels, November 5th, Brewer, Maine. I'm calling you out. Not a match. I even made sure I wasn't even put on the card. Just me and you in the middle of the ring. I already cleared it with the captain. Security's not gonna stop you. You don't have to buy a ticket. You can even come in through the wrestler's entrance. Just meet me in the ring. Face to face, man to man, and let's finish this. You like beating down people? You like hurting people? Like making their real lives hard because of what you've done to them? Come face me like a man, not like a coward. And you can bring your little masked Goomba with you. We all know who it is, Kyle. Come on, we know you guys have been butt buddies since you've been coming to the I.W.E., Ryan Michaels. So November 5th, Brewer, Maine, bring yourself to the ring, Ryan Michaels. Face me. And let's end this. So that when I'm done with you, my life will go on and I can start smoking these cigars because I enjoy it. Ryan Michaels, November 5th, Brewer, be there.
And burn, just wait your turn. You might have time to speak. There barely was a lesson learned.